Hey guys, Joe back again, another episode of Getting Junk Done, and today we're cleaning a chainsaw. Now I never knew this beforehand, but chainsaws need to be cleaned regularly. This is before I had any experience whatsoever. And this past weekend, we cut down about, I would say 40 or so trees on the off-grid property in upstate New York. So we're gonna clean all the gunk out of this, all the sap and sawdust, and we're actually gonna change the blade as well. Now, this isn't really much of a job, to be honest with you, but it's something that you cannot take for granted. I mean, look at all that crap in there. You let that stay in there, your chain's not gonna get oiled, and your chainsaw itself is gonna suffer. And then your cuts aren't gonna be as good, you're gonna go through chains a lot faster than you should, and it's just a waste of money, to be honest with you. So if you clean this up ever so often, you're gonna be doing yourself a ton of favors, and your chainsaw is gonna be very happy. So first thing I'm gonna do is get rid of this thing. And like I said, we're replacing the chain. I've already sharpened this chain a couple times, and it just needs to be replaced as far as I can tell. I'm thinking that we're gonna do a better job with a fresh chain. So I'm gonna get this off, and then I'm gonna show you how I clean everything out of the clutch cover. So the clutch cover, this is where you get all this crap just caked up in here. Sawdust, dirt, anything that the chain gets itself into is gonna end up here eventually. You combine that with the oil from the oiler, and you make a sludgy mess. So all I do really is get at this with my finger, maybe a toothbrush, get all this stuff out of here. And some guys actually hit it with compressed air, which is not a bad idea, but I'm gonna try and keep this all in one spot, and the compressed air will probably put this all over the place. So I'm gonna get in here with some picks and toothbrushes and what have you, and get all this out of here. Well, it looks a lot better than it did. It's not quite there yet. I'm gonna hit it with compressed air after all. So I'm gonna let this kind of sit for a few minutes, and I'm gonna move over to the actual main chainsaw and see what I can get done on that. I'll come back to this with the compressed air. I gotta turn my compressor on. So anyway, here's the chainsaw itself, and there is sawdust everywhere on this. So, I mean, it's the nature of the beast. These guys are dirty machines in the first place. They run dirty, they stay dirty. It's kind of a thankless job trying to keep them clean, except that you do get thanked in the respect that you don't have to buy a chainsaw every year if you take care of a good one that you get once. So I splurged, I got myself what I think is a decent chainsaw. Are there better ones? Sure. Yeah, there's more expensive ones, of course, even from the same company. However, I'm not a logger. I'm just a guy who needs to cut some trees down every so often, maybe cut some firewood from time to time, and this will hopefully be the last chainsaw I ever buy. If you're curious, it's the Husqvarna 450. It's not the 450E or the 455 Rancher, it's the 450. So you can look it up and see the specs on that. Came with a 20-inch bar. It's a 55cc engine, I think it is. It's either 50 or 55, I can't remember offhand. But this is the chainsaw I opted to go with, and I got it off of Amazon for, I think it was around $400. So it was a decent investment in terms of its monetary value, but in terms of its effectiveness, I've cut down almost 100 trees with this so far. Same chain. I sharpened it a couple times, but never changed the chain until now. And we'll see how far this new chain gets me. Alright, well, I'm going to clean this guy up a little bit. Enough of me yapping. And let's see what it looks like when it's done. All right, well, I'm starting to think that this is good enough for the chainsaw. I got the clutch cover almost finished. Like I said, I want to hit that with some compressed air, but to be honest with you, it's looking pretty good. So now we're going to take a look at the bar, and I'll show you what I take a look at specifically for the bar. Now for the bar, we got the end that goes towards the engine, and then you got the end that goes out towards the tree. So what I like to do with these guys is to, if you look carefully, there's a hole here. I don't know if you can see that, but these are the attachment points here for where it connects to the chainsaw. And this allows for adjustment left and right. So as the chain loosens up a little bit and stretches, you can adjust it slightly so you can get a better fit. Now, this chainsaw bar, as most chainsaw bars are, you can actually flip them over. And what's going on here is there's got to be a way to develop, or to deliver rather, the bar oil to the chain itself. So what they have here is a little hole here that I was pointing to a moment ago. And there's one on each side. It's in the same orientation. So whenever you flip it over, it's in the same spot. So you can flip this bar over, and that hole is where the oil comes from the chainsaw and gets delivered to the interior of the bar and soaks up into the chain itself. So this bar is used. You know, you can see it's a little dirty and stuff like that. So I'm going to wipe this down with some kind of cleaner. I'll probably try a brake cleaner and get all this dirt off. And then we're going to clean out those holes so there's no gunk in the way of getting the oil to the chain. And that's pretty much all there is to it. That's what I do to clean off the chainsaw when I'm done using it for a weekend or what have you. I don't do this after every job. If it's one tree or two trees or whatever, then it doesn't necessarily need this much of a clean. And like I said, I cut about 40 trees down. It was dirty. The bar went down into the dirt a couple times. There was snow. So it got snow on it. I mean, it was a dirty job. It wasn't one of those cut the tree down, you're done kind of thing. So I'm gonna reassemble this with a new chain that I got from Oregon. And this one is supposed to be the next step up in terms of professional or kickback or what have you. So not many people realize this, at least the homeowners probably don't. I didn't at one point, is that there are different levels of chain. And the stock chain that comes with these guys aren't always the longest lasting or best aggressive cutting chain. Now, you get a more aggressive cutting chain, you gotta have some experience because it is gonna kick back and it's gonna pull the chainsaw out of your hand if you're not careful. And who knows where it's gonna end up at that point. You could get seriously hurt. So, be careful and what have you. I'm thinking about doing a video in the future on the different types of chains specifically for chainsaws similar to this, since that's what I'm most familiar with. Now there are other things that you could do on top of what you just saw to help make sure that your chainsaw is ready to go at a moment's notice. The air filter is a commonly overlooked item that kind of just gets forgotten about from time to time. I like to have an extra one on hand that I can go in there and just replace it whenever I need to, and I like to keep it in the case with the chainsaw itself. The other item that I forgot to film and I left out, not on purpose, was to actually check the groove around the bar itself. The groove is where the chain rides and goes around and around. That groove will sometimes get clogged up with sawdust and wood chips and the like, and those items actually soak up the oil, preventing the oil from getting to the chain, therefore defeating the purpose of cleaning it in the first place. So make sure that the bar is good, not only cleaned, but have the groove checked out. And then, like I said, the air filter is a commonly overlooked item. Well guys, I hope this video helped, and if you did like this video, please click like, comment, share, and subscribe. And as always, I can be found on Twitter @GettinJunkDone. Thanks for watching.